Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to discuss about Mach coupling. So first of all, let's see the outlines of the session. First, function of Mach coupling, then construction of Mach coupling, then working of Mach coupling, then advantages of Mach coupling, and at last disadvantages of Mach coupling. So let's see one by one briefly. So here you can see this is the Mach coupling. Sometimes it is called as sleeve coupling, sometimes it is called as box coupling also. So this is the classification of the couplings as we have discussed in earlier video. So let's start from the first, box or Mach coupling. So here you can see box coupling or Mach coupling is the category of rigid coupling, and that is used to connect the two perfectly aligned shafts. So here you can see these both shafts are perfectly aligned. So let's start with the function of the box or sleeve or Mach coupling. This is the simple figure that definitely you can use in the examination, and this is the 3D figure to understand the function and construction of the box coupling. So first I will give you the name. This is the driving shaft. This one is the driven shaft. This is called as the Mach or sleeve or box. This is the key. Now see, first of all, the function. It is used to connect two shafts. Here you can see driving shaft and driven shaft, which are perfectly in axial alignment for transmitting power. In this figure also you can see driving shaft and driven shaft, both are perfectly in axial alignment. Now the construction. It is the simplest type of rigid coupling made of cast iron. It consists of a hollow cylinder, here you can see, whose inner diameter is the same as that of the shaft. It is fitted over the ends of the two shafts by a sunk key, here you can see. Now working. Torque is transmitted from input shaft, you can say it is the driving shaft, to the sleeve first through the key, and from the sleeve to the output shaft, or you can say driven shaft, through the key again. So very simple, power is transmitted first from the driving shaft to the sleeve through the key, and then once again from the sleeve to the driven shaft through the key again. Now advantages of the box coupling. So this is the another figure to understand the construction. First, it is simple because it has only two parts, that is the sleeve and key, to transmit the power from driving shaft to the driven shaft. Next, since it has no projecting parts, hence it is safe to use. Next, it has compact construction, you can see in this figure. It is cheaper compared to other types of couplings. Next, disadvantages of the box coupling. It is difficult to assemble or dismantle. Since it is a rigid coupling, so it cannot accommodate any misalignment between the shafts. Due to the absence of flexible elements, it cannot absorb shocks and vibrations as in the case of flexible coupling. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate it.